The last component that we need for the enemy is the enemy AI script. This class will act as the enemy's brain and will make decisions based on the information given to it by other scripts. Add a new script component to the enemy called enemy AI. Open it for editing as usual and prepare it. Let's start as usual with the public variables of the class. Our enemies are going to have three states: patrolling, chasing, and shooting. They will be stationary whilst shooting, but we will need to allocate a speed for patrolling and chasing. 2 and 5 should be appropriate defaults for these. When reaching the last sighting of the player, or the waypoints of their patrol route, enemies will wait for a brief moment. We need to store the amount of time they wait when patrolling and when chasing. The last public variable we will need is an array of transforms to act as waypoints for the patrol route of each enemy. We need several private class variables. Firstly, we need a reference to the enemy sight script. Next, we need a reference to the NavMesh agent component. We will also need to know the player's position, so we will need a reference to his transform. We will need a reference to the player health script. And lastly, we will need a reference to the last player sighting script. We need a few more private class variables. Firstly, we need timers for the chase and patrol wait times. Finally, we need an index to keep track of which of the array of waypoints is the enemy's current destination. Now we will use the awake function to set up our references. Now we will create all the empty functions we will need so that we can write calls to them as we proceed. We will start with update, as that is where all of our functions will be called. Next, we will have functions to represent the states of the enemy. The first is shooting. This is the highest priority state, and though it doesn't matter which order the functions are listed in, it makes more sense to have the highest priority ones first. The next highest priority state is chasing. Finally, our last state is patrolling. Now that we have our empty functions, let's return to populate them. In update, we want to have the conditions for each of our states and then a call to the appropriate function. The highest priority state is shooting, and we want this to occur if the player is in sight and is alive, so the player's health must be greater than 0. If the enemy is not shooting, then the next highest priority is chasing. We want the enemy to do this if the last personal sighting of the player is not the reset position, and if the player is also alive. If the enemy is not in either of these states, then the enemy should be patrolling. Now that we have the state logic finished, we can populate our state functions. The only thing we want to do when shooting is to stop the enemy from moving. We do this using the stop function of the NavMesh agent. The rest is handled by the enemy shooting script. Next, we can move on to the chasing function. The first thing we want to do is set a new destination of the last personal sighting of the player. However, we only want to do so if the distance between the enemy and the player is greater than some small margin. So first, we create a vector from the enemy to the last personal sighting position. An appropriate margin is 2, so we will compare the square magnitude of this vector to a value of 4. If it is not some small distance away, we will set the NavMesh agent's destination. We want to make sure that the enemy is running, so the NavMesh agent's speed should be set to the value of chase speed. Now we need to check if the enemy has reached its destination. To do so, we will see if the NavMesh agent's remaining distance is less than its stopping distance. Once the enemy reaches the last sighting, we want him to wait, so we should start incrementing the chase timer. We then need to check if the enemy has been waiting long enough. And if he has, then the enemy will start his patrol route again to look for the player. To make this happen, we need to reset the global last sighting of the player as well as the enemy's personal last sighting of the player. And since we've stopped waiting, we will also reset the chase timer. One other thing that we need to do in this function is state that if we're not near the last sighting of the player, the chase timer should be 0. This is because the player may be spotted elsewhere whilst the guard is already in pursuit, meaning that we need to reset to 0. The patrolling function follows a similar pattern to chasing. First, we need to set the NavMesh agent's speed appropriately. Now we need to check whether the waypoint index needs incrementing. We need to check if the enemy is either near the destination or has no destination. The enemy has no destination if they have just lost track of the player, signified by last player sighting being set to the reset position. Now, similar to the chasing function, we need to increment the timer. As before, we check if the enemy has finished waiting. This time we need to increment the waypoint index so that we can set a new destination. First, we check whether we're already at the end of the array of waypoints and set the index to 0 if we are. If we aren't, then we increment the index. And at this point, we need to reset the timer just as in the chasing function. Also, as before, if we are not near the destination or the destination is not the reset position, then we need to reset the timer. Since the rest of the function may have changed the destination, we can now update it. That concludes the script, and we've almost finished making the enemy. Save it now and return to the editor. First, let's tidy our script into the Scripts Enemy folder by dragging it from the Assets folder into the Scripts Enemy folder. Next, let's make a prefab out of our robot guard so that we can make more guards. Drag the char robot guard from the hierarchy into the prefabs folder in the project panel. Now we need to make instances of the enemy prefab and place them around the scene. Now that it is a prefab, duplicating the existing one in the scene will make another instance. So let's use Command D on Mac or Control D on PC to create a duplicate and place it at -19, 0, 37. Then find your guard in the scene. Next, duplicate again and place the new one at -29, 0, 43.5. So that there's less confusion, we will rename the robot guards now. Reselect the first guard near the bottom of the map and add _001 to the end. Select the second guard and rename him with _002 on the end. And finally, add 3 to the last guard. The last stage of making the stealth game is to create waypoints for the enemies to patrol. To make it easier, we are going to organize the waypoints under a parent game object. Create an empty game object and call it waypoints. Go to game object, create empty, and rename your object. Set the position to 000, so that each of the waypoint's local position is also the global position. Duplicate the waypoints object and rename it waypoint 001. Now make it a child of waypoints. Because our waypoints will be made up of empty game objects, we won't be able to see where they are in the scene view without selecting them one by one. To solve this, we can use 2D gizmos. Gizmos are simply icons that represent where an object is in the scene view. And you can set these by clicking on the icon to the left of the name at the top of the inspector. With waypoint 1 selected, click on the game object icon and then choose Other. Then search for waypoint. And you'll see an asset in the project panel called waypoint. This flag icon should be applied to your waypoint. You can then collapse this menu. It should look like this flag in the scene view. Now we need the rest of the waypoints. Duplicate waypoint 1 10 more times and rename so that each of them has an individual number. You should end up with waypoint 1 to waypoint 11. Now that we have all the waypoints, we can position them around the level as we wish. The first 4 we are going to use for the patrol route of robot guard number 1. The positions for waypoints 1 to 4 are -26.75, 0, 7, -25.4, 0, 14.5, -18.8, 0, 14 and -18.5, 0, 7. Centering on the building on the left-hand side of the map, you should see that there are 4 waypoint flags now set up. Now we need to reposition the final 7 waypoints. These make up the 2 patrol routes of the robot guards near the end of the level. The next 4 waypoints have the following positions. Select waypoint 5 and position at -10, 0, 36.4. Waypoint 6 is at -10, 0, 44.8. Waypoint 7 is at -17.9, 0, 44.8. Waypoint 8 is at -17.8, 0, 36.4. And the last 3 waypoints have these positions. Waypoint 9 is at -27, 0, 35.4. Waypoint 10 is at -17.9, 0, 43. And finally, waypoint 11 is at -28.2, 0, 43. Looking at the end of the level, you should now see that our flags are set up as shown. All that remains is to apply the waypoints to the appropriate enemies. First, select Char Robot Guard number 1. And scroll down to the enemy AI script. From the hierarchy, drag waypoints 1 to 4 in order onto the Patrol Waypoints field of the enemy AI script. They should now appear in order as shown. Now select guard number 2 and drag on waypoints 5 to 8. And finally, guard 3 will need waypoints 9, 8, 10 and 11. This unusual order is because we're using one of the same waypoints as guard number 2. So be sure to drag them on in this order. And don't forget to save your scene and save your project. Now that we're finally ready to test our game, we can check for any errors and anything that we've forgotten to assign within the project. Let's press play and test our game. Remember that our controls for sneak, using switches, and attracting attention are left shift, Z, and X respectively. The first thing to notice here is that as we've died, Unity has shown us an error at the bottom of the screen, an unassigned reference exception. The variable death clip of player health has not been assigned. So what we need to do is fix this before we continue testing. So I'll stop play, reselect the player, char underscore Ethan, and we can see here that death clip in the player health script has not been assigned. This is a very common problem when writing scripts with public variables. Often you'll forget to assign references, and Unity will prompt you to do these as they are called by a script. So simply select the audio folder and drag the end game audio clip onto the death clip. Now let's play test again. And we'll deliberately allow ourselves to be shot by the guards. And now we can see that our game plays back the end clip and resets the level. Let's continue to playtest. Thank you. And now that we've reached the end of the game, we've verified that our game works properly. Congratulations, you've now finished the stealth project. If you want, try out the stretch goals that we've set out in the next assignment. And we very much hope you've enjoyed this project. Thanks for watching.